Man, who is ready for some? This is crazy, guys. I have not missed. I watched the Tampa Bay game earlier, and I was cheering for Brady, and I went highs and lows of up and down, and oh my God, you know what I mean? But here's the thing: it's not my team, so I'm not like losing it like I normally would with a Patriots game. So I'm just kind of having fun, but I'm kind of cheering for Brady, and then they end up losing, and now we're watching this. We are watching Mike Tyson versus Muhammad Ali right now or something. This is unbelievable. I haven't even been able to see GCW. Apparently X-Pac just showed up in ECW. The Kansas City Chiefs and Buffalo, this is a massive slugfest that's going on right now. I have never seen anything like this. No one has. I mean, this is a... Like, here, I'll punch you in the face. Now punch me in the face. I'll punch you in the... You punch me in the face. I mean, this is crazy, dude. This is one of the most wildest games ever in football. Like, this will be remembered for a long time, man. I'm watching this game almost from the beginning to the end here. And, man, this is crazy stuff, dude. The quarterbacks right now, what they're doing... I think Josh Allen has had to make tougher plays here towards the end here, but they've both made just insane plays. Mahomes is nuts. Josh Allen is becoming friggin' Montana that can run. I mean, it's crazy. I mean, I'm a Patriots fan, and I'm actually kind of rooting for Buffalo. You know what I mean? I feel so bad for those people. Even though the fans have been douches to me over the years, I don't know. But this is crazy. This is crazy, man. I'm probably a little bit behind you guys, so. Dude, my kids just went to bed. Like, but I've been watching the last 30 minutes. I've been downstairs being able to just absorb every single play. But earlier I was watching it on my phone. We had dinner and everything. And, I mean, Derek Hance in the chat nails it, man. I mean, you knew it was going to be nuts, but you didn't think it was going to be like this. I wouldn't think anybody would have thought it would be like this. And they're going to... Oh, man, what a tackle! Man, Kansas looked like they had a first down right there. And then a huge tackle. This is so jacked up, man. Whoever got the ball first, I felt like is always going to win. I can't believe, man, that Kansas has the ball first. Whoever gets the ball first. This is crazy. This is crazy, guys. What's up, J-Rod? Oh, look out. Oh, Kalisa open. Kansas got a first. Man, how bad would it be if this game ended on a touchdown? Who right now doesn't want to see a field goal kicked that's good by Kansas? And then Buffalo kick a field goal that bounces off the post and goes in and is also good, and this continues. Who doesn't want to see that happen? Dude, what is going on? They got a yard. What's up, Derek? All four games this weekend have been amazing. Dude, everything's come down to a friggin' field goal kick, too. This is wild right now. This is wild. Dude, Josh Allen looks frozen on the bench right now because he can't believe that they came back the way they did. And then, I mean, you thought you won. You thought you lost, and then you came back and won. You thought you lost, you came back. You thought you lost again, you came back, and you thought you really won that time, and then it's tie. I mean, here comes another big first down for Kansas City to the 40. Oh, my God, bro. Come on, Buffalo interception. Guys, let me show you my FanDuel chart. Can you believe this? I'm such an idiot. I played Gore today. I didn't know Gore wasn't playing, dude. I had no idea. Look at my scorecard here. Dude, look at this. Can you see this? Gore, a zero. And I've got Gabriel Davis. I've got Davis with 48 friggin' points. Buffalo Bills defense only has 1 point. I need Buffalo Bills to get an interception here. But they're going to keep running it. And there's... Oh, God. Come on, interception. I need an interception, guys. If the Bills could get an interception, the defense gets an interception, and then on top of that, and then on top of the interception, Davis gets to catch another touchdown pass. I mean, I don't know. This game is nuts. What's up, John Wills? This game is insane. I had Buffalo winning, but this isn't looking good with the every team that gets the ball scores, and Kansas starts the overtime with the ball and is already on the 30. This isn't good. Oh, wide open. Oh, my God. Buffalo needs to get an interception or a fumble. Come on, man. Oh, my God, no. Oh, my God, bro. Tyreek Hill, too. I've got Hill on my team. If he could get the ball, that'd be nice, but... Wow. If they score a touchdown, the game's over. Oh, my God, bro. I'm a Patriots fan. I'm rooting for the Bills a bit. I can't believe it. But I don't even care. This game's just nuts. I just can't believe I got to witness this insanity of it. Like, this is wild, dude. No! Cleese. Oh, my God. Buffalo Bills fans are jumping off towers. Oh, my God, man. Oh, my God, man. Buffalo Bills fans are eating their own ass right now. Buffalo Bills fans are eating their privates right now, man. One foot, 2 foot. Oh, he got it. That's a touchdown. That's a touchdown. That's a touchdown, man. The Bills just lost. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Oh, my God, man. I feel so bad for Bills fans, man. I feel so bad for Bills fans. I feel so bad. Andale Peasy, I'm sorry, bro. Oh, man, I wanted you guys to... I'm sorry, man. God damn it, man. Josh Allen played like a maniac. Oh. Oh, my God, man. Wow. And the Bills lose again. Man, that is sad that someone had to lose that game. Oh, my God, bro. What the hell, dude? That game was insane. Oh, my God, man. Damn, that was crazy, man. That was one of the craziest games that we've ever seen. Andy Reid will celebrate with some KFC, Trey Walter says. Yes, no doubt about it. Andy Reid is having a bucket of chicken. Oh, shit. It's gonna start raining, man. It's raining, man. Hallelujah, it's raining, man. I'm gonna go out. I'm gonna let myself get absolutely soaking wet. It's raining, man. Mahomes Hallelujah. Is celebrating. It's raining, man. There is mess up, man. They talk. game. I just can't believe what we just saw. The Buffalo Bills crushed at the end. Mahomes stays at the top of the throne.
Time for my boy Macaulay Culkin to win the AFC next week.
Oh, you think your buddy Macaulay Culkin's going to win next week? Gerald Armstrong coming in with the $18. Gerald, what's up, man? Gerald, thank you, man. I can't believe that. Shout out to Gerald Armstrong for the $18. Macaulay Culkin. Man, what? How are you guys doing from football today? This has been... Oh, God, I just so many things you want to go back and say about the defense, and oh, it all came down to the coin toss. You knew it. You knew whoever got the damn ball first was going to go score. The defenses were just gassed, and the offenses were playing magic tricks, man. Oh, my God, bro. I feel so bad for the Buffalo fans, bro. That is unreal.
You donated 50 bucks. I'm going to take my dick out because you donated 50 bucks. You donated 50 bucks, motherfucker boy. I'm a rich motherfucker.
Whoa.
Football, oh my God, this is crazy. Bills and Chiefs, this is crazy. I swear to all that is all Allah that I'm going to all over myself and then I'm going to all over a fat slobby.
Oh. Harry Steve, 50 dollars
donation.
Holy shit, Harry. Steve, are you serious, dude? Coming on here for a few minutes to talk football, and Harry Steve drops a bombs away. He must be a KC fan. That was some fun football, man. I think you... I'm not sure what that word is on the bottom there, but it might be the... it might be the... I don't know. But anyway, Harry Steve, thank you, man. That is the definite top dono of the stream. Harry Steve, man, we just started, too. And Harry Steve drops a 50 bomb. Chat, what's up, man? I mean, even Brady earlier today. I just can't believe Tampa Bay earlier didn't go into some kind of prevent defense. What the hell were they doing, leaving the whole secondary just open? Like, I just don't understand what they were doing. I don't get that. A coin is determining the game. I know it. It's always irritating. You know what I always thought was, why not give each team the ball once? I don't understand that. Like, okay, it's overtime. You get the ball, and then you get the ball. And the first person that outdoes the other person wins. So you get the ball. If you do nothing, the other person gets the ball anyway. And if the other person does nothing, then we start again. If the other team goes and they kick a field goal, well, then you have a chance to kick a field goal. Unless you score a touchdown, then you win. But why would you just win when the other guy doesn't even get to touch the ball? You know what I mean? So that part of it always drove me nuts. But then again, the clock has already expired in the real game. So if there were time remaining, the next would score. You know, so I sort of understand the theory of it. But I don't know. There's something about it that feels icky to me. I don't know.
Super Chat Party!
Oh, yeah?
Jeff Jarrett wrestling now in Hammerstein Ballroom.
Damn, man. A lot of people are talking about GCW right now. I almost wish I did watch it tonight, but I was so tied up with everything, and I just didn't want to do anything tonight. I really am sick of everything, but it would have been a fun night to watch GCW, I think, and react to it. So I am a little bit down that I didn't do that, but it's... By the time I thought about it, it was already an hour into the show, and I was like, oh, it's already too late to review it, you know, unfortunately. You know, I see X-Pac showed up, you know, Jeff Jarrett's there. So, you know, I do wish that I had, you know, planned a way to watch it. I can't believe that I fucking lost. I can't believe that I only won $8. And part of the reason I only won $8 is because I didn't know Gore wasn't playing. I took him as a running back, too. That's a huge spot. Like, any other running back here
would have gotten 15 points. Do a little basketball dance off the concrete. I mean, I'm just so sick of you little meth head devil worshipers. I'll be honest. I'd like to take a big bite out of your face.
Just do the college ot rules. Not this year's college ot rules. They were dumb. Oh, get ready for Bengals Niners 3.
That's a great point. Gerald Armstrong, yeah, exactly. Just do the college rules. You know, just do those. But, yeah, Gargutz, I think, watched it. Let me see what he's saying. But no doubt, Gerald Armstrong. Anything would have been better than, anything's better than just, oh, I touch the ball, score, you, I win, yay, button, done. You know what I mean? I just don't get that. That bothers the hell out of me. All right, let me go see what's up with Gargi. Gargi.
He's eating.
Oh, how's the show been?
Issues or, how was what?
How's the show been?
Chill, I guess. I have no idea.
Well, I mean the GCW show.
Oh, it's been pretty good, man.
That's good. Everybody's
I've
really
been watching these people beat the shit out of each other. It's entertaining.
Yo. What's up, baby?
Shit, just watching.
Hang on, I'm getting shit down. I can't hear you.
Bro, let me tell you something. Buffalo and Kansas just went through a slugfest, bro.
Oh, no shit.
Like, dude, they traded touchdown after touchdown in the last 3 minutes of the game. It was nuts. Dude, that was like the craziest football game I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, shit. What happened to the stream? Oh.
But yeah, I just popped in to say what's up. What's going on right now? What's Jeff Jarrett doing something?
Yeah. I don't know who he's facing. I just got here, but
he's facing this guy. A lot of people that have filmed like in heavy metal,
yeah,
wrestling, they're on here. So I'm just like, dude, that's tripping out. Like Alex Colon was on here. That was a shit show. This guy is ASF. I filmed. That was just like Spot City.
Is this the?
My Discord dropped. I'll restart it. Let me restart my Discord, son. Man, yeah, dude, I can't believe that call.
Looks like
but what's your what the hell is your team? I mean, you're a Raiders fan, right? So what are the Raiders going to do?
Hey, what's up?
What's up?
Just want to say this has been an epic weekend of football.
Yeah.
First three games ended on last second field goals, and then Chiefs versus Bills had three lead changes in final 2 minutes and also overtime. Both offenses deserve a lot of credit.
Yeah, dude, I feel bad. I almost feel kind of bad that somebody lost this game. I mean, especially with the way the Bills, you know, they beat the Patriots and then they couldn't get past the Chiefs here after seemingly winning twice. It's, you know, I mean, if you're a Bills fan, you thought you won this game twice. You thought you lost the game twice. And then when you really, finally, really, really thought you won the game, then you didn't. I mean, dude, that's got to be just... This has to be one of the most devastating losses that anyone has ever had to deal with, other than, like, maybe the Falcons against the Patriots in the Super Bowl and that comeback. You know, if you're the Atlanta Falcons in that comeback game, I mean, you're feeling pretty crappy about that, but damn, man, what do the Bills have to do to win a Super Bowl? What in the world did they do to somebody in another life? I mean, never won a Super Bowl. Been to multiple Super Bowls and, you know, didn't win. The Patriots finally are, you know what I mean? They beat the Patriots finally. Josh Allen is amazing. The team is amazing. And really the game just comes down to who had the ball last. Who got to have the ball last or first in overtime, really. I mean, dude, this is one of the most insane games. I can't stop saying it. This game just... started ramping up. The offenses just started ramping up. How about those times where they seemingly were about to tackle Josh Allen a couple times and he ducked it and, you know, staggered away and ran the ball like a he looked like John Elway. Looked like fucking John Elway in the Super Bowl back in 99 or 98 or whatever it was. I feel horrible for Andale Pizzi, man. I feel really bad for him. He drove all the way down there or whatever to see this game. He's from Buffalo. Oh, the poor Buffalo fans, man. They got to be losing it. I mean, dude, there's stuff getting broken right now. Like, where's the Pittsburgh guy? Was that a Steelers fan? I mean, dude, the guy's freaking out.
I'm going to be hanging from the bathroom. Don't ask me to do nothing. This is nothing. I'm going to kill myself.
I'm going to kill myself.
You're going to find me dead.
I mean, that's what's going on right now, man. But yeah, I guess you'd rather have the Bills lose here than in the Super Bowl. I don't know, man. Listen, Bills fans have been mean to me over the years. As a Patriots guy, fan, whatever, the Bills fans have been scumbags to me. So I've hated them. I've wanted to see them, whatever. But I wanted them to kind of win. I felt bad. I'm like, you know what? Get one. Let's go get one, goddammit, you know? Go get one. You know? I would never root for the Jets, ever. But the Bills, you know, I would, you know, get one. You know, the poor fan base up there. Oh.
You're going to find me dead! I'm going to kill myself!
Dude, they've got to be broken up and ranting. I would be freaking out. Oh, well, hell of a Sunday night gaming. Just starting my Madden up right now. What's up, chat? I hope everybody's doing good. We're going to sit here, hang out, talk about the football games today, where we're going here with the playoffs, about how I picked Gore today and got a zero spot on my fantasy team. And what sucks more about that is I picked really good picks besides that. I mean, Brady was kind of a dud, right? But, I mean, dude, Fournette, 27, fucking Cupface, 26. Pringle got 10, that's something. Tyreek Hill, for sure, did 23. You know, Rob Gronkowski was kind of a bust too, man. I almost fucking went with Buffalo here. I almost chose Buffalo players here. I would have gone with Josh Allen, and then I would have picked another Buffalo player. And man, do I wish I did. I picked Gore like a moron. I wasn't thinking. And there was no chance for me to fix it. So there's that problem. And, dude, if I had just taken Buffalo, the Josh Allen and another Buffalo player instead of Gore and Brady, and I would have taken I couldn't have taken Cleese for fucking tight end. I would have taken somebody else probably, but they would have certainly probably done better. And of course, Gabriel Davis got 48 points.
Looks like my little last.
Like I blew it.
A shaving.
What's up, Joe Jesse Garguts? NFL having some epic games. Chiefs versus Bills best game of the weekend. Wide receivers and tight ends on each team are incredible. By the way, the Bucks versus Rams looked almost exactly like Falcons versus Patriots.
Yeah, the Bucks versus the Rams, it really did. I can't believe the Buccaneers defense didn't play some kind of deep prevent. I don't know what they were doing. I don't know why they didn't create a box, like create a zone. Like you get guys playing deep at the 30-yard line to box them in. That way if they make a big play and they get to the 50 or 40, whatever, but at least you didn't give up a fucking touchdown or whatever, or the field position. Oh my God, the Soundwave 92! Buffalo's tears right now. The Buffalo Bills.
You're gonna find him. Yeah. I'm gonna kill myself.
It's raining, man. Hallelujah. It's raining, man. There is best of men and tall, dark, blonde, clean, rough and tough and strong and free.
Bud Light. It's the beer. Of the queen.
God bless Mother Nature.
Drink up, motherfuckers!
What a fucking game. That will go down as one of the best divisional games of the last 20 years.
Yeah.
We have to deal with Allen and Mahomes for next decade plus.
Yeah, we're screwed.
The rest of the AFC is in hell because there is no answer to stopping those two.
Yeah, that's a great point. As a Patriots fan, and Soundwave 92 is also a Patriots fan, we're about to pay the penance for this. You know, we got 6 Super Bowls with Brady or whatever it was. Yeah, we're about to pay the piper now because these guys look nuts right now. Josh Allen and Mahomes are nuts at this point. And the only way you're going to beat those guys is with a stellar defense and certainly a good quarterback and an unbelievable defense. Like, the defense that you're going to have to beat those guys, like, is crazy. Dude, I just pulled off a crazy play in Madden. That was crazy. What's up, chat? How you guys doing? We're hanging out today. We're going to be taking your calls, talking football, talking about everything that's going on. I'm getting wet. I got Madden up right now. I'm playing Madden. We just got a Madden game going. It's Sunday night gaming and football talk and whatever else. We're going to talk about everything. We're going to take calls in a minute. Going to go back to the Discord in a second. I'm about to score on the Jets, so that's always fun to do. Let's see if we can do it. And down to the 1-yard line. What's up? He will improve, still young. Bills will be back next year. Yeah, dude, I mean, like, Josh Allen is crazy. Like, he's really good, dude. That guy is really good, dude. He's a tank. He's very Elway-ish a little bit. Oh, I dove over him. Come on, get in there. In there for the touchdown. Brady owns KC. Imagine if Brady came back to the Patriots. That'd be funny. That wouldn't happen, but people always ask me, why aren't you mad about Brady? Why aren't you more mad at Brady? And the reason why is because I feel like he stayed with us longer than someone else might have. I feel like he gave us extra years. He took pay cuts. You know what I mean? He did do that. He took pay cuts and stayed longer than I think most people would have, you know? And so I think some people were like, get out of there. What are you doing? You know? And he was like, no. GCW is wild, man. I guess people are having a real good time watching GCW. I wish I got to watch it. I could have watched it, but by the time I made the decision that I had time to do it, it was already an hour into it, and I went, oh. You know what I mean? Otherwise, there's a possibility I watch it and review it later, but I feel bad that I missed it live. Josh Allen should punch Leslie Frazier in the nads for going prevent. Yeah, exactly. Everybody. I thought that the Buccaneers should have gone prevent, but they didn't. And then in this game, it's like now they shouldn't. It's just there's no right answer. Yes, like I literally saw the play that I would have called the other way, go the other way. Boom, hit that guy. Tom Buddy played his final game. Tom Brady played really well tonight. He got the Bucs back, and then just they couldn't hang on. The defense couldn't get the stop. Brady did everything he needed to do. At the end of that game, he did it. They came back. I couldn't believe the Buccaneers came back. I had sort of written that game off at one point in the... Oh, man, this guy's going to score a fucking touchdown on me. Oh, he just did you see the dive miss? Oh, my God. This game's going to be nuts, too. This game's going to be as nuts as the ones we saw a minute ago. What up, Pressure Jones? Well, I think one of the problems is... What up, Cody? I think one of the big problems is you're going to have to get over that KC hump, man. You're going to have to beat Mahomes. Right now, Mahomes is your fucking Brady. Mahomes is your goddamn Brady. Josh Allen is Peyton Manning. I don't think Brady's retiring. I think Brady's got another year or two. Regardless of what happens, another year or two. Oh, it's not the way I wanted that to go. Haskell, what up, man? Holy shit.
Shit bum!
Let's see what's up.
Rams versus Tampa Bay. Man, what a crazy ending. Bills versus Chiefs. Oh, yeah? Hold my motherfucking beer, beer.
Right? Haskell 420.
The OG. OG donator.
Haskell, what's up, man? How about that, man? That was something else. Those games today were nuts. And I saw most of them, but earlier in the day I was doing stuff with the family and I was kind of watching on my phone and I couldn't believe it, but I saw the last 20 minutes full of the Tampa game, like on a big TV instead of my phone. And I saw most of this game down here on the computer. Haskell, thank you, man. What's up? These games were wild.
Super chat party!
Big throw! He's got it! We got it! We're going!
Oh, yeah?
Fan put GCW almost in the Discord, Jesus Live.
Oh, you did? Thank you, man. You put the link in there? Alex Oley.
Alex Oley.
Didn't get the touchdown. Oof. Thank you, Alex. What's up, dude? What would you give? What would everybody give GCW tonight in the chat? I'm going to put a poll up in a second, actually. I wonder if people watched everything. You're actually exhausted. Imagine if I can't imagine if one of these teams was a team that I was like really cheering for. It was my team or something like that. You know, that would just make things nuts. We can't get in the end zone. Let's get the poll going. Touchdown! What's the flag for? Why is there a flag? What the hell was the flag for? Did anybody see what the flag was for? I don't even know what it was for. Oh. Oh my God. Joe, do you think? Oh, man, I wish I got him to fumble. If this was your Jets, you'd be in the ER right now. I put a poll up. What was the best? GCW, Bills. All right. Oh. Can't believe I didn't get a touchdown there. The toe was out? Oh, his toe was out of bounds? Oh, my God, bro. Are you serious? I can't believe that. I cannot believe that. Randy Viper!
Oh, yes, I'm hard for Cronin. I'm coming hard.
That's gross, Randy Viper. What the hell's wrong with you? All right, we got to change this coverage. Haskell, thank you, man. And that was not Haskell. That was Randy Viper. Haskell was right before that. Intercepted! Let's go. Let's go. What's up, big bad ads? This guy gonna quit? Oh, he quit! What a bitch! You are a Jets fan. Sorry, Haskell. He quit. It's high.
You're gonna find me dead! I'm going to kill myself!
Man, the Bills. Oh, my God. The Bills and Chiefs trade blows. Trade insane blows. And then in the end, the Bills, who just miraculously kept coming back and then took the lead and then lose. Yeah, Keemstar is beating people up in the streets right now. Jesus. God damn. Buffalo was robbed, says Mustafa. Well, how were they robbed? God damn, this is so insane, man. I'm getting so many comments. I'm looking on my Twitter right now. I've got so many comments, man. So, like, I mean, this is people that I don't even know are messaging me that I ever barely either talked to or didn't ever DM before. They're just like, Joe Buffalo's my team, man. We're going to do it. Like, dude, I've got DMs from people that said, I can't believe we're actually going to do it. Oh, no, you didn't. And then I got people, same thing, Kansas, like, Joe, I don't know, bro. My Twitter is insane right now. Wow. Dude, say what, no matter what, that game was nuts. I won $8. That was it. I won fucking $8 is all I won. And Gabriel Davis with 48 points. How the hell did I not win more than this? And part of it's because Buffalo's defense. 48. Oh, my God. And I won $8. I can't believe it. Oh, my God. I'm beyond befuddled. That game was nuts. And after what happened in Green Bay the other day, too, I talked to Shell earlier, and I was like, I don't know how you're even awake. If I was Shell, I might have been in a bunker. The poll's coming in. Let's take a look at the poll. 65 votes. 65 votes. Damn, 67% saying what was the best, obviously. I mean, I can't believe anything else would win, but oh, they just fumbled. Oh, I caused a fumble in my game. Oh, a big hit and a fumble. Oh, my God, I wish you guys could have seen that. Maybe you can. I can't look at an instant replay, it looks like. Man, here's the fumble. Here it is. Look at boom. Big fumble right there. I just caused a fumble. I'm going to say it 7 times. Oh, we got all this running room. And all this running room. And he breaks another tackle. Touchdown. Let's go. For your FanDuel pool, says Haskell. What do you say, Haskell? Joe, how many points did that team score in total? Did my team score on my FanDuel? 162 points. 162 points. I came in 34,000th place. I was in 34,000th place of 327,000 people. And if I hadn't picked Gore, who wasn't even in the game, I don't think, and got zero, you know what I mean? I might have been in 10,000th place and won fucking $400 or something. That really screwed it for me. And picking Brady, too, and you know, Brady was one of the worst quarterbacks I could have picked today, I think. I think everybody else scored more, I think. I don't 100% remember, but I'm pretty sure that that's the case. Dude, this was nutty. Oh, my God. Let's see if we can get him. I'm playing the Patriots. Patriots versus the Patriots. Whenever I play, I'm playing a real player. Yeah, I always play a real human. I play the online teams where you can build your team and play other people and whatever else. They usually try to match you with the closest team to yours. Doesn't always happen, but usually you get somebody with a close overall to you, but I don't know. I find I always play harder people or people that, like, bought all their cards or whatever. Bro, y'all Buffalo fans must be disappointed. Yeah, dude. Andale Pizzi's probably, like, dousing himself in gasoline right now.
You're going to find
Buffalo right now. The Buffalo fans just can't catch a break, man. They just can't win. These people just can't win, bro. Josh Allen had like 56 points. Yeah, see, if I had picked Josh Allen or Mahomes, like that would have been way better.
Super chat party.
What's up, Alex?
Oh, yeah.
Chiefs 49ers Super Bowl, my prediction.
Ooh, man, Chiefs and 49ers, that's going to be tough to see through all that red. Wait, wasn't that, what was the Super Bowl where the lights went out? Why do I feel like that was the, sounds like, what was the Super Bowl when the lights went out? Man, Josh Allen had 56 points. And I had Davis, too. Man, if I just had Allen. And somebody else from Buffalo, too. Oh, my God. I should have done it.
Yo. This whole city, we're gritty. Yo, we might eat our own shitty. Yeah. Survive off our motherfucking own feces. In Philly, we're gritty. In Philly, we're gritty. This whole city, we'll eat our own shitty. In Philly, that's why our mascot looks like a...
Josh Allen, sad news. Allen and the Bills lost to the Chiefs. He did everything he could, but a mixed white and darky Mahomes pulls it out.
Oh.
Rumor is Allen is snorting coke in the locker room right now. Also, Allen is seen talking a pointed hood out of his bag.
Oh, man. He's taking the hood out of his bag. Did you guys see that I made the... somebody said the other day that it was the hood in them. That's why they were saying the bad N-word.
Super chat party!
Intercepted! Intercepted!
Oh, yeah?
Halftime Snoop Dogg, Dr. Dre, Eminem.
Oh, man. Alex Oley, thank you, bro. Football News Now, thank you for that donation before Football News. Yeah, the halftime show looks pretty decent, right? Pretty cool. It's always the whole crew from, what the hell was it with Dre? What was his thing? Interscope. The whole goddamn former Interscope crew is together. Alex, thank you, man. Bro, from the people that were in the stadium live, see the Buffalo lose, I could hear the screams through the TV. Can you imagine those fans? Man, I'm killing this guy right now. Intercepted, and now we got the ball. Good little run there. I'm going to run it again. Thank you for that dono, my friend. Harry Steve, the top donation at $50, man. I can't even believe came on here for a little fun for a few minutes tonight, and you guys are dropping bombs. Oh, that ain't going to get us there. Brown's kicker was... Oh, you got to be careful with him, right?
I'm going to kill myself!
First down. We got it. We got it. Browns. Josh Allen said N-word back in his what? A lot of people have. Buffalo fans, have you guys seen the guy that flipped out on those girls at the coffee shop? I almost lost it on Twitter when I saw that. That guy pissed me off. You seen this guy? He's like fucking crazy. I'm going to play this clip. You've probably seen it, but I'm going to show you this guy. This guy's whacked. All right, let's go. Yeah, you got to see this guy, man. This guy's whacked. Buffalo fans, have you guys seen the guy? This guy's out of his mind. He's going to be a hero. Kicking was super clutch this weekend. Yeah, dude, the kickers really did. The kickers were heroes. I was hoping for a double field goal kick in that overtime where one hits the post, but it goes in, and they trade field goals. That would have been fun as hell. Imagine how fun that would have been. That would have been wild, dude. Appreciate it, Jax. What's up, man? Thanks for subbing last week. How you doing? I literally saw one of the Buffalo players look into the sky disappointed. Yeah, I mean, you would look into the sky. You'd be staring into the moonlight. We're going to the end zone on this one, guys. We're going end zone. No, we're not. Oh, shit. He was covered. I was going to lob it. I was about to throw a lob right to the back of the end zone. It would have been intercepted. Oh, my God. Thank God I didn't do that. But unfortunately, I had to take a sack. Now I lost. Easy field goal. Still should be pretty good here. Should be able to get it. Take the two-score lead. Now, those were free points. I mean, the guy, interception. Dumb to kick off the ball into the end zone with the 13 seconds. I agree. And the announcer said that, too, and I thought the same thing. I was like, no, man, get that in play. Dude, if they did that, they probably would have won. That's a great point. We didn't talk about that at all yet. That's exactly right. Dude, that was crazy. I remember yelling at the TV. I'm like, oh, this is a no-brainer. You kick this ball. I almost thought about a squib kick or like some kind of anything just that they have to play it. You just do not want to be I'm calling the timeout. You just do not want to be – you don't want to be letting them just take it at the 20. I thought that was so ridiculous. I could not believe that, man. And then the announcer said it too. Really got to be a big reason why that happened to him. Oh, my God. That should have been intercepted. That was a 4-on-1. That should have been intercepted. That goal the Panthers made at tie. I didn't see the goal. What do you mean? I didn't see the hockey game yet. I haven't seen any hockey highlights yet today. He just safetied himself. Is this guy on drugs or something? What's going on? Who's going to the Rams old stadium for the Rumble Saturday? Yeah, what's up? You guys all going to the stadium? Oh, this guy quit. That's two in a row. We're on a two-game winning streak, everybody. Two-game winning streak. Let's go. Let me write it down. Sunday Night Gaming. What's up, chat? Everybody in the chat get weird. Win streak 2. Oh, shit, what'd I do? Win streak is 2. We'll see what we can do. I'll probably give WWE 222 a try. I'll probably give it a try, Man, I can't get over the look on Josh Allen's face, man, when they came back the second time. And he finally just started letting loose. And when they went into overtime, he looked shocked right from the idea that they were in overtime. He was in shock. He was already kind of like in a coma. I mean, who would have thought that would happen, dude? 13 seconds. If the fucking ball had just been kicked to be fielded, it would have taken 5 seconds, 6 seconds, 7 seconds off the clock. It would have taken three to seven seconds come off the clock. Can you imagine that? There would have been one play for Kansas. And even if they did hit a bomb, they would have been kicking it from the 50-60. Dude, how awesome would it have been if the kicker was about to kick the longest? If the kicker hits the kick, it would be the longest field goal ever in the NFL playoffs or whatever. Imagine that if that had come down to that, how awesome that would have been. He's about to kick a 60, whatever that is. It's probably 66, 67 yards. He's about to attempt a 67-yard field goal. Can you imagine that? And he kicks the ball, and it hits the fucking crossbar and goes up in the air, and you don't know where it's going to come down. It comes down, hits the crossbar again, and then rolls across the crossbar, and then either goes in or goes out. I was thinking of some sick shit during this game. Like, I was like, oh, imagine if that happens. Like, oh, I was just thinking of the most insane shit, and it all had to do with the poor fucking kicker. I just kept thinking about it. Like, oh, what would make this even more insane? How can we make this even more insane? I'm just thinking all kinds of dumb stuff. Oh my God. Josh Allen, it's okay, bud. You still made millions. That's a good point. I'd blow somebody right now for $1 million. I'd blow someone every day for a year for $1 million. I would eat out like Harvey Lee Oswald's ball sack for like a full week. Oh boy. That was a really good play. This guy looks pretty good. We're on a 2-game win streak, but this guy looks really good. He's run. He keeps running out of that pocket every time. Okay, let's go. Let's go cover two spy. Oh, man, I just missed him. Oh, wow. Oh, my God. You got to be kidding me. All right, we're going to have to change my whole way of playing defense in this game. That was crazy. He's moving on every play. Wow. Wow, this guy is off to the races every snap. Okay, 8 to 10 seconds because they would have downed. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, that was, it came down to exactly that. Don't kick the ball into the end zone. Oh, now he's doing onside kicks. What a prick. Oh, my God. Oh, boy. Fucking hate people that play like this. Oh, boy. Intercepted, bitch. Manual interception. Take that, you fucking fancy-ass fuck. Fuck this guy. Briscoe's open challenge is the main event in GCW. Oh, it's going to be the Bucks, right? Or somebody, right? Oh, no. Is it? Who's it going to be? Buff Bagwell. Wait, you're saying Buff Bagwell's there? The Buffaloes are now called bitches. Buffalo always talked a lot of shit to me, man, as a Patriots fan. Buffalo hated me. I still kind of was rooting for him. Oh, man. Come on, man. You got to catch that and go. Oh, get in there. Oh, my God. He had the block. I just had to go left. Oh, my God, bro. 4th and 2. We're going for it. I can't believe we didn't get in there on that one. It's probably going to be what? Oh, FTR. Yeah, that makes sense. FTR. That's who I was thinking of. I mean, I was thinking of the Bucks first, but there was another team I couldn't think of, and it was FTR. Yeah, probably be FTR. Imagine if it was the Bucks, though, dude. Think about that. Oh! What a great little sidestep there to get the first down. Oh, my God, I didn't get the first down. FTR had a match with Rock and Roll Express last night. See, that's what I said, too, so I didn't think that they would wrestle again tonight. Smarter to kick off 14 seconds is 3 to 4 plays. Yeah. That's what I just don't know.
You're gonna find me dead! I'm gonna kill myself!
It's gonna be Breezango. Breezango's here. I can't believe I won $8. I'm going deep into the end zone, guys. Let's see if it works out. Are you serious? That's intercepted? Oh, my God. Dude, fuck this game right now. Dude, fuck this game, dude. Are you serious? How the fuck could that be intercepted? Dude. I should have had points there, man. Something. I shouldn't have gone for the end zone. I should have just kept grinding at the short plays like I was doing. Huge mistake, man. I should have just kept grinding it up. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, dude. What is this fucking guy on right now? This fucking blows, dude. I'm on a fucking goddamn win streak, TC, you fucking cunt. Fuck you. I'm on a win streak, brother. You're on a win streak, too, of catching AIDS. I'm going to call a timeout. Oh, my God, bro. I can't believe this fucking guy. Oh. Oh. I'm going to lose my win streak. I'm going to lose my fucking win streak to this fucking mongoloid. I should have scored a touchdown a minute ago. Fuck. Oh, my God, bro. There's social justice messages in the game? Is there really? Where? I didn't even notice it. Now I got to climb my way all the way across the field again. Can't believe that I fucked that up. The Briscoes versus Matt Tremont. That would be, What up? I don't know, man. I wonder how the Bills fans are doing, though. They got to be freaking losing it. Dude, can you get your feet in bounds, for Christ's sake? Every play. Oh, the wrong guy caught it, but it whatever. Like, the wrong guy caught it, dude. Did you see that? What was that, dude? That was hilarious. That might have been one of the funniest plays I ever made by accident. My mother came over today. She goes, "Oh, I brought you meatloaf." And I'm like, "You brought meatloaf back to life?" My mother came and brought meatloaf. I haven't had meatloaf in like 3 years, I feel like. And I'm like, that is so morbid. She's like, "Oh, yeah, because he died. I know. I heard about that." I'm like, that's fucking weird. And then you made meatloaf like the next day? It's very bizarre. Oh, we got it. We got it. Oh! Antonio Gates making magic happen. Are you fucking kidding me? Well, there goes my winning streak. There's no way I'm going to win this now. I mean, this guy's too crazy. He's changing it to a running play, it looks like. Oh, boy. Boom. This guy's fucking crazy. It's like I played two pieces of garbage, and then I played a guy who's fucking nuts. I couldn't play, like, someone mediocre. Test the team for steroids. Nick Gage enters Hammerstein Ballroom. Nick Gage, he's demented and erected. Good old Nick Gage. What up, Nick? Shout out to the Nick. I wanted to pull the crystal. Good old Crystal. Tommy's Crystal. Well, I don't know, man. Pressure Jones, what up, Pressure? Shell is teasing Joe. No, I think Shell is not feeling very good. But she, probably especially not after that Green Bay shit. MKD, you want to play some Mortal Kombat? Is that what you're saying to me right now? You want to go down for some Mortal Kombat? Mortal Kombat. Timeout. Oh, boy. Wow, ton of special guests at GCW. Yeah, X-Pac, JJ, Sabu.
Super Chat.
A lot of people
party.
There. I've been told a lot of people are there. That won't even be on the
show. Solid Monster and Midget Man reviewing GCW tonight.
I mean, I would expect so. They've done everything else. Remember when I used to do New Japan? Nobody did that. That was awesome. The wrestling world is saturated. Play some Soul Calibur? No, right now. I want to see X-Pac beat up Sabu in a back street just beat down. Dude, there's so many. There's been so many people too that didn't even see this football game because they actually were watching GCW. We're getting our asses handed to us right now. Fuck off. This game's fucked right now. Hornswoggle and Marco Stunner there? What's that sex tape look like? You did everything before everyone. Yes. No, it's not really it's that. It's just that, like, man, remember when I, like, I just remember when, like, I used to be able to do stuff and I felt like, oh, this is...
Aaron Rodgers going to New England next year.
That's what I said. Like, it would be funny if he went here. I just feel like it was fun. It was funner back when I felt like, I'm the only one doing this. This is fun, man. Like, this is like the Wild West. There's only, like, there was like a couple of people, but almost nobody. And it was like, this is fun that I get to cover this and no one's covering this. This is so cool. And now it's just like everybody and their mother. Everybody and their mother. And it's like that, it just takes away a little bit of the, you know, what was so fun about it. Don't come out of the end zone, you idiot. Well, it was awesome when everything was, you know, when it felt like very special. I don't know how to explain it. I'm also the first one to take his everything he does and take a shit on it. I hope so. Hell, that's my team, RM. What's up, RM? Dude, did you watch that whole game? I can't believe I was like 100% like Buffalo was, oh my God, they didn't do it. I thought they had done it, and then they didn't do it. And then they didn't do it. It was like, it was just crazy. I'm going to back out of this now. I'll give it to him. 2-1. Our two-game win streak comes to an end. There goes our win streak. It's out the window. Everyone knows it's out the window. Yup. Yo. Woo, it's been a long day. How you guys been? Thank you to Harry Steve for the top dono, man. The $50 coming in. Rodgers to the Steelers, says King. We're all, yeah. What's it going to be like in Pittsburgh when none of the women have to fear? Oh, that's all fucked up. Oh, yeah, let me play that Dunkin' Donuts or whatever, this coffee shop thing that I was talking about earlier. This guy that was nuts. Dude, if you did this to my daughters, I would find you and beat the shit out of you. I would straight up beat the shit out of this person. Look at this guy. If you haven't seen this, it's fucking wild. Dude, stop playing this fucking music. Copyright me. No. No, here we go. Here we go. A lot of people were sending this to me, and I was like, Jesus. I don't know what happened here. The coffee got made wrong or something? I don't know.
I have no room to yell at
us. I want to speak to the fucking person who made this drink. Is that you?
No, well, it wasn't
me. We don't know
me.
Who made it, so.
You don't know who made it?
There's four of us here.
I get it that, like, they're kids or whatever, probably, like, teens, or maybe they're not. I don't know. Whoever, whatever it is, who cares? But the guy's losing it, which is, you know, sometimes people get mad. I've been mad in restaurant places before. And I've been like, what the fuck, dude? Like, and I've flipped out, too. Like, I've flipped out. But not like this, where I'm like, you know, like, I've flipped out where one time McDonald's had me waiting. I ordered a Big Mac and, like, a couple of fries and a McFlurry. That's what I ordered. It was, like, something for Gavin, me, and Leah. And I'm sitting there, and they're like, could you pull up to over there? You know, or whatever. Oh, no, it was Dunkin' Donuts, too. It's happened at multiple places, but the McDonald's one is the one where I really freaked. And I'm like, yeah, okay. And then, like, fucking 15 cars go by. Like, I'm parked there. I'm like, okay, fries, Big Mac, McFlurry. What's taking so long? And so I'm sitting in the thing waiting, and then the guy behind me gets his food. Guy behind him gets his food. Guy behind him gets his food. Guy behind him gets food. And then before you know it, there's no cars in line anymore. And a new car pulls up to the microphone and then pulls up to the window. And I go, all right, that's it. I went in. Actually, I didn't go in. I went up to the window. I was like, hey, yeah, hey, remember me, the guy that paid like fucking 15 minutes ago? Like, what's going on? Like, I ordered a fucking hamburger that's normal, fries that are normal, yet all these people are getting served after me, including a guy who just pulled up and now he's getting his food. What is going on? And they never really gave me an answer. And then they eventually, then they just gave me my food through the window. I'm like, wow, awesome. That was cool. Like, I love, like, waiting, like, whatever the fuck. And, like, they, oh, I remember what it was. They set me off more because the lady goes, oh, let me see your receipt. Like, she didn't give me one of the things that I, like, was in the order. And I'm like, all right. I'm, like, fucking losing it. I'm hungry. Like, I'm fucking flipping out. But, I mean, it was nothing like this. It was more like, hey, what's up? Like, I'm the guy who's been waiting 20 fucking minutes for regular fries and sandwich that everybody else would order. Like, why am I not fucking, like, whatever? And then they were like, oh, let me see the receipt. Oh, I know what it was. They gave me everything, almost everything. They gave me almost everything. And I said, oh, what about the McFlurry? I'm like, all this time, like, did you just forget about me? Like, I don't know. And it didn't start that way either. That's the other thing. I said, I went up to them and said, okay. I said, yeah, I'm still waiting for my food. And the lady was like, you're still waiting for your food? And I'm like, yeah, I'm still like waiting for my food. And she's like, oh, well, we'll bring it out to you. And that's when I lost it. I was like, no, you're not going to bring it out to me because you haven't brought it out to me yet. I'm like 15 minutes at McDonald's, 15 cars, 15 minutes. This something's not right, you know? So, and then they gave me everything. And I'm like, oh, the McFlurry or whatever. And she's like, did you get a McFlurry? I'm like, yeah, I did. It's not here. And then she was like, can you get your receipt? I'm like, yeah, it's in my car. But I ordered a McFlurry. It's on the order. You probably have it. Then she was like, well, we can make it for you. I'm like, yeah, no shit. And I fucking, dude, I wanted to flip out. I wanted to just, it was like, I want to lose my mind. But this guy goes overboard, I think, for sure.
I have no room to yell at us.
I want to speak to the fucking person who made this drink. Is that you?
No,
well,
it wasn't
we don't know who made it, so.
You don't know who made it?
There's four of us here, so we honestly don't know.
Fucking stupid, fucking ignorant high school kids.
Now, she is an idiot. She's kind of a dink, right? Like, we obviously don't know, or whatever she says. Like, there's four of us here. We obviously don't know. But it's like, you ever seen an adult talk to kids who work at a place like this when they're really talking to them? You talk to them kind of like, listen, I understand that. But from my point of view as the customer, like, this is not at all what I wanted. It's all wrong. Could you fix it for me? Or like, you got to be careful, like, when you're doing these, like, whatever, something like that. Somebody made it. Just be careful, you know, because this is not right at all, you know. Stuff like that. I've heard people do that. You know, and I, which is understandable, but this guy's coming unglued. You stupid fucking ignorant high school kid. Yeah, they're high school kids. So you're not exactly gonna get the best fucking perfection.
Bye. I want to speak to the fucking.
Bye. Man. Okay, you can call corporate whatever you want. Goodbye.
Yeah, I'm
sorry.
You're on camera.
No, I don't care.
And then he called her a bitch. I mean, that's fucked up, bro. How are you going to call these young girls working at this store? You know, and they may be shitty. They maybe are. Maybe they are being bitchy. Like, maybe they were doing something. I don't know, bro. But how are you going to start a fight with, or continue a fight, or get into a fight with these girls working at this place? You know what you do? You just go on and you leave a review. You go on and leave a review. They were nasty and mean. That's what you do. If they were doing that. But this guy's the nasty, mean one.
Give it to me right now.
What? Dude, how are you going to throw a fucking drink at a girl like that? What a fucking pussy this guy is.
Give it to me right now. What?
And when she's not looking. When she's not looking.
Super chat party!
Oh, yeah?
The problem is these people think they deserve $15 for bare minimum work they don't.
Well, I don't think that. No, that's a whole nother thing to get into, James. I don't care what these people think. They shouldn't be treated like that. I don't care if I don't care what they're doing. But here's the newsflash. They should be getting paid $15 an hour, but everybody should be getting paid an extra $10, $20 an hour from what they're getting paid. That's the problem. Yeah, the McDonald's workers should be making $15 to $18 an hour to $20 an hour. But everybody else should be making that much more as well. That's the problem. You know what I mean? Inflation is so crazy, out of control right now, that everybody should be making way more money because we can't survive. $40,000 a year is now the old $25,000 a year. And $30,000 a year, yeah, is like the old $20,000 a year, whatever the math is. $50,000 is the new $35,000. So it's like, dude, yeah, I think the McDonald's workers should be getting $15 to $20 an hour. But everybody else should be getting that much more as well. So then the McDonald's would still be the low totem pole, but it would be more survivable than it is now. The living wages, the wages are fucked. Our wages are fucked, guys. No matter what, everybody's wages are fucked pretty much. Unless you're in like a very, you know, a big company in a capitalistic way, in a sales thing or in a big, you know, corporation. But regular jobs, middle class, lower and middle class jobs are nothing at this point. Like, things are fucked. So, but James, I get it. I don't think that, you know, when everybody else makes an extra $5, $10, $20 an hour, that doesn't mean I think McDonald's people should now make $25 an hour. That's crazy. But, I mean, everybody should be making more money than they're making. There's no doubt. With the inflation and the amount of money that stuff costs and how much cost of living has gone way up out of control, of course.
Right now.
Dude, I can't believe that he waited till this girl wasn't even looking. He whips the drink at her when she's not looking. I don't even know how old these girls are. He's calling them dumb high school girls or whatever, but I don't know how old they are, but dude, fuck this guy. You're a guy, or you're a dad, you're a guy, you're a man. This guy worked for Merrill Lynch, apparently, by the way. He just got fired, I guess. They found him. They found this guy, which normally I'm not in favor of. I'm never in favor of finding the guy's job or whatever the fuck people do. But this guy was a piece of shit. Good. Should have called him already.
Fuck you! I want the fucking telephone number right now.
What does he say here? I want the phony telephone?
Shit bomb!
What the hell is he saying here?
Both NFL games today were insane. Really good football. Watched the whole GCW PPV tonight.
Ooh!
Was really good until Bulldozer and MDK Nick Gage botched the main event against Briscoes. Lasted 6 minutes. Dropped my rating to a 6.
Nick Gage botched the main event? Really? What the hell is going on? Dude, he botched the main event? They botched the main event? Are you serious? Really? Holy shit, dude. I didn't even know. I didn't know I was going to be able to watch it tonight, man. I'm working like fucking 60, 70 hours a week. I have no idea. But I probably could have watched in the end. Wow. God damn, man. Let's go back to this, Now, we don't know what happened before this, but again, I still think that no matter what, even if these women were all like, oh, these girls were all like, hey, fuck you, like, or whatever, like, I still don't think that the guy should do this. Like, you should be a man and be like, all right, these fucking ladies are fucked. All right, I'm out of here.
I want the fucking telephone.
Oh, he said, I want the fucking telephone. So she's trying to call the police now. And this guy's like, I'm going to stop you from calling the police.
Jealous.
I want the telephone. Shut the fuck up.
You shut up. Get out. You can call corporate whenever you want.
You're a fucking idiot.
Bye.
You're a fucking idiot.
Okay, good for you. Bye.
I want the
Bye.
And, you know, the girls aren't calling him a dumb fucking idiot either. He's just like, all right, good, get out. Get the fuck out of here. This guy's lost it.
Bye.
Shut up.
You shut up. You're not going to tell me to shut up the fuck. Who are you? Who are you?
Fucking immigrant loser.
What?
And then he called her an immigrant loser. That's not going to do well on you. That's not going to do well on social media. Wow, he called her a fucking immigrant loser. How do you know she's an immigrant, first of all? How do you even know she's an immigrant?
Tell me to shut up the fuck. Who are you? Who are you?
Fucking immigrant loser.
What?
Fuck you!
Oh, maybe he said he's an immigrant loser.
Well,
because she said, who are you? And then he said, immigrant loser. So maybe he was just answering her, like, hey, I'm an immigrant loser.
You? Who are you?
Fucking immigrant loser.
What?
Fuck you!
Bro, call the police now.
Dude, he tries to get in the fucking door. I hope they already called the police before that. That's fucking crazy, dude. And then they found the guy, by the way. They fucking found the guy. They found the guy. Jim something. Linazo. Ianazo. I don't fucking know. They fucking found this guy in like 3 seconds. That he works at Merrill Lynch. They found him in like 2 seconds. It was crazy. They found his Twitter. They found his LinkedIn. I don't know how they found him. How the fuck do you find this guy? So fast. Like, how do you find this guy? He's a wealth management advisor, managing director. Damn, from New York, of course. This shit's crazy. Like, I mean, what are you doing? By the way, his Twitter is gone. Everybody found his Twitter and were tweeting at him. But his Twitter is now gone. He's now ghosted. I'm not in favor, usually, of canceling people. See, I don't know why the guy loses his job. Like, I don't understand why the guy, like has to disappear from social media or whatever. But what, like, I would be fine with him just being charged with assault for throwing the coffee at the girl. I think he should be charged with assault, intimidation. That's about it. I don't think there's anything else. I mean, maybe he used a credit card at some point. Oh, yeah, you're right. Maybe the people working there knew his name from the girls. The girls are probably 16, 17. You're fired, Jim. You're fired, Jim. Yeah, I heard that Merrill Lynch fired him already. Don't know if it was botched or not, but they spent a shitload of time after the match dicking off. I don't know, it definitely sounds like the ending didn't go 100%. That's true, yeah. Arnold was in a car accident. We actually talked about that on Monetize This. I think that's why I did the poll with him on it, because he was in the car accident. We talked about, dude, that was one of the funniest parts on Monetize This when we were making fun of Arnold.
I thought they were the Terminator. I had to terminate those civilians. I tried to terminate the...
Oh, man. I don't know, bro. Why was he snapping like that? I don't know. I don't know why he was snapping. We don't have the full video. You know what I mean? There could have been something done to provoke him, I guess, right? But at the same time, it's like, dude, why would you do that to these girls? GCW was underwhelming, says Elitist. 80% of the show. For 80% of the show. Man, I thought people were going to be all about it, man. Kansas City and Buffalo might have been probably more entertaining. This was one of the most entertaining football games I've ever seen in my life. But most people did say GCW was good. Most people seem to like GCW tonight. You know? Yeah, I don't like that either. It's like, dude, what if the guy was having a bad day? And if he did something good, he should be in trouble legally. Like, he assaulted the girl. He should have assault charges. I don't know why he has to lose his job and life and everything else like that. But he was arrested. The guy was arrested, apparently.
I don't know if she gave it to you, but he did get arrested. And he did get charged with, like, breach of peace and stuff. But according to them, it's not considered assault because I'm not hurting. Anyway,
I guess it's not assault because the coffee was cold and she's not hurt. But I don't know, man. That was definitely something.
But he did get arrested and he did get charged with like breach of peace and stuff. But according to them, it's not considered assault because I'm not hurt in any way.
Oh man, I just don't understand that. Even if these girls sucked, even if the girls made shitty coffee, then laughed at them and whatever the fuck, I don't care what they did. Almost. He went way above whatever they were doing, for sure. He's a dum-dum. Bank of America? Oh, I guess he got fired by Bank of America. I thought he was working for Merrill Lynch. Dude, I'll tell you what, though. If that was my daughter's work, if my daughter was working in a shop like that and that dude showed up and did that, and I was like, what did you do to provoke that guy? Like, what happened? You know what I mean? And it was like, nothing. You know? Even if she did do anything, I'd be like, dude, you're doing this to these girls working at a coffee shop? That's fucking crazy. I wish I was in that coffee shop. I would have super kicked Jim. See, these people are just stupid, though. Like, people like this fucking lady.
Hi, Baron Online. This man claims to have won several awards from you in his LinkedIn profile. You may want to consider revoking them unless you're fine with a racist man who assaulted a minor representing you. It's like, just people like this are just fucking losers, you know? It's like, yeah, the guy's a scumbag. Everybody sees that online. Great. He's probably going to go to jail for something. But, oh, now, like, this lady is spending time trying to get his awards taken away on LinkedIn. Like, what kind of loser are you?
Oh, I just wanted to say he's got these awards. You should think about taking them away. Like,
this person is a loser fucking psychopath. You know? That guy was so wild, bro. Oh, wait a minute. So there's more stuff coming out on this. Oh, see, here we go. We're starting to get more answers. Guys, here is the reason why he flipped out. His kid could have died. Why isn't every business super conscious of peanut allergies? Not to excuse his behavior, but it does explain it. Oh my God. I can legit, like, identify with this. My son has a peanut allergy and he'd be dead. My son would be dead. So if this guy was like, it can't have peanuts in it or it can't be peanuts or my kid dies, and then someone just gives you something with peanuts, you're going to fucking get angry. You're going to be like, dude, what the fuck?
Wow. Wow. But why doesn't this guy know what to do? Instead of doing this, you don't do this. Instead of doing this, you pull out your camera and you start filming the girls and be like, so you guys just make shit with peanuts and don't care if you kill somebody? Like, my kid could be dead right now. It's a mistake, but you can kill somebody. You know what I mean? And if they fucking keep up with being like, fuck you, dude, then take a fucking video of it. But he made the mistake of just flipping out. That's what it is, though. His kid had a peanut allergy. That explains it. That explains it. He was more upset because of his kid, his little kid, and they're older. But at the same time, I don't know, bro. Now some kid's dad doesn't have a job. But still, he still went overboard, though, man. He went way too far. Like, I've been given stuff that had peanuts in it by accident by people, and I'm like, dude, my kid's dead. If my kid eats this, he's dead. Number one, don't order out at places, right? Number one, don't order anything that you know at all could be peanut whatever. That's number one. Number two, if you do order, you're putting trust into someone, so you better double, triple check. Because people don't understand allergies. And imagine people with crazy allergies to weird shit. Like, peanuts is fairly known. Stuff that's weird, like, you never get that shit right. You can't even try to shop. Or you can't even risk being like, oh, I have an allergy to whatever the fuck, salt. You know, you can't even do that. You're going to get killed. So, it's, you know, I get it. Oh, I see what happened to his kid was hospitalized for an allergic reaction to the drink. 100 ways he could have handled it better, but not a random response. So this is what happened. His kid was hospitalized for an allergic reaction to the drink. Wow. So he came back in to be like, who fucking made this? Wow. But again, they're fucking kids. They're teenagers. They don't know. They're retarded. You know what I mean? But he made a mistake in calling the girl a dumb immigrant. Like, that was stupid. You know they're all going to be recording you. You called her a dumb immigrant. Like, that was a mistake. Like, ugh. It does make a little more sense now. It's not just he's mad about his coffee and he's yelling at them. It's his kid could have been killed and his kid was in the hospital. So I see that. But yeah, man. Dude, we are living in the Orville. We are living in the episode of the Orville with the Social Score. Did you guys ever see that? We're living in the fucking Social Score shit. Dude, Antonio Brown... Dude, did you guys see Antonio Brown's tweet? Antonio Brown tweeted out, Bucks eliminated with him holding the sign up. What the fuck? Oh, my God. Oh, my God, dude. Fucking lose it. Oh, that is way too funny. Oh, my God, dude. AB is trolling the fuck out of people. This is crazy.
Have you seen either of these two men?
You're kidding me, right? Everybody knows these guys.
Why does everyone know them?
They got corrected like a month ago.
What do you mean by corrected?
This episode of The Orville in Black Mirror, this is where we're going, guys.
Oh, my God.
John, your badge.
Oh, my God. What did you do?
Commander, look.
Again, what you are seeing here is a man performing what appears to be a lewd act on a statue of Mella Giffenden. This was recorded just a few minutes ago and uploaded. The feed is understandably not happy about it, and voting has already begun. The badge code has been identified, so get out.
Basically, you can downvote people, and when you downvote people, eventually they kill them. Like this guy gets like millions of downvotes for grinding on a statue of some hero woman or something. I mean, and
what's going on here?
Grayson to Orville.
Mercer here. Go ahead.
Captain, there's something going on down here. Some kind of social hysteria surrounding Lieutenant Lamar.
Show some respect for your country, jerk.
Hey, chill out.
Kelly, what's happening?
John dry humped a statue.
What?
Get out of the way!
We gotta get out of here now. I'll contact you from the shuttle. Grayson out.
This episode from 2017 is with the social credit score and the videotaping of people or the camera stuff. And, taking things way out of context or in context or whatever, bro, this is happening. They're going to start hacking people up soon. You're going to be unpersoned, unidentified. And that's if you just have the wrong outburst. If you're the wrong-looking person and you have the wrong outburst and it's recorded at the wrong time or the right time, right? Like, let's say somebody comes up to you, slaps you in the face and goes, you dumb white boy, I'll kill your family. And then he slaps your kid in the face and slaps you. And then the guy flips out and runs after the guy. And then someone goes, whoa, there's some guy chasing a guy and starts videotaping it. And then the white guy goes, starts fighting back and like punching the guy and being like, don't ever fucking talk to me like that again, you motherfucker. And then he calls him like a racial slur back. And then they get that on video only. It's like that guy could lose his job, lose his life, lose everything. And it's like you didn't see how that started. This guy assaulted him, And if they didn't have the video of that, you're fucked. You know what I mean? And then it's like, well, it doesn't matter. Even though the guy assaulted him, that guy, he was racist or whatever. It's like the world is insane right now. Alex Jones is right sometimes. That's the best. That's probably the best saying. Alex Jones is right sometimes. That's true. Oh, man. What up, Jeff? Bring in the apocalypse. But, yeah, I don't think that guy should have been obviously going that haywire on them. But, I would get it real. I would flip out, too, in a way, if it happened to my son. Someone says to me that there's nothing in it. Dude, they already did it to me. They did it to me at the coffee store months ago. What was it? It was actually last year. I said, oh, is there any peanuts in this? Because my son has a peanut allergy. And they were like, no, I don't think so. They said, no, there's no, it should be fine. And I said, okay, I looked at them again and I said, I always say, yeah, okay, because if there was any peanuts in this or anything in the mixture or anything at all, my son will die. And I looked at her and she goes, hold on a minute. And she was like, okay, we have almost nothing in here with peanuts, but of the 12 assorted donuts you got, one of them is made on equipment or something like that with that handles peanuts. And I'm like, oh, okay. And she was like, but none of the other donuts have peanuts. And I looked it up, and it said that none of them did have peanuts at all, except for the chocolate stuff that was, or the special stuff that was on top of this particular donut. But even that, it wasn't probably peanuts. But I said, all right, yeah, I won't give them that donut then. We're fine. And she was like, okay. But even she was like, oh, yeah, it should be fine. But it's like, no. It's not one of those things where, like, what if this happens? Oh, you should be all right. Go ahead. It's like, no. If you're not right, my kid's dead. Like, you'll be, what I mean? So, there you go. Cross-contamination can happen, yeah. But I think we're going to wrap it up here. Thank you, D. Welsh. Thanks, everybody, for hanging out, man, tonight. What a football game. Like, this has been nuts. I went 2-1 in Madden tonight. No EpiPen? Oh, yeah, my son does have an EpiPen, yeah. My son has... We have multiple EpiPens. He's got to have, you know, the one at school. He's got one in the house. We've got an expired one in the car just as a backup, but it's, you know... They're a lot of money, too, now. It's fucking ridiculous. That happens now, Mark Smith. It's a good point. But what? But they end up, but you know, at the end when they end up killing the dude. You know what I mean? What the fuck? You dish it out, but you can't take it, Turtle Boy. What the fuck? Went the time out for that. You can't attack Awandi and D. Welsh. At least someone supports me. Sean's view, we are living in the worst time in history. Well, we're living in, I think we're living in the worst time of our, we're living in the worst time, I feel like, of the last 40 years, 50 years. Maybe Vietnam. That wasn't so good. We're definitely out of the 80s, 90s, and 2000s. This is the worst time we are living right now. The last 3 years have been the worst 3 years in my entire life. There's no doubt. And I'm not talking about my family and stuff. That's been fine. But, I mean, as a world, as a whole, it's felt like the worst, you know, just with everything that's going on. Vince McMahon throwing shade on your son's name. By terrible booking. I don't know, man. Anyway, thanks to Harry Steve for the $50, man. That was the top dono. Great football day. Thank you guys for being here. I had a lot of fun, like I said. Sorry to the Bills fans. I mean, that was unbelievable. Thanks to D. Welsh for $5. James Mesner, $5. Boom. Really mysterious. Alex Oley, Football News Now, and Randy Viper, plus Haskell 420 was here. The Soundwave 92, Debe Senior Farm, Bullfrog's Family Dies, Gerald Armstrong, and Harry Steve with the $50 to start this night off, man. Schlong's View Entertainment in the chat. Niners and Bills in the Super Bowl. Yikes. It's too bad, man. I can't believe the Bills. I cannot believe Kansas City and the Bills put on that slugfest. Unreal stuff. Anyway, I'm out of here. Hope you all have a great night. Buffalo Bills fans, this is for you.
You're gonna find me dead! I'm gonna kill myself!
We'll see you tomorrow for the Monday Night Raw review. Become a patron on patreon.com/JoeCronin Show for the latest Patreon episodes, music downloads, former podcasts, former friends, and tons of new podcasts coming in the future. So now... Take it off for Daddy down below. Sean's view can suck me.
Suck me off, Schlong.
You're gonna find me dead!